Hello everyone, xHedra here, bringing you episode 39 of Forever Stranded, a mud pack by Gaming with Sheridan. So in the last episode, we finally killed our two witters and we crafted a mob prism in which we captured the, well, we didn't capture, we copied the witter mob pattern, which means that once we get into Woot and we build a tier 4 Woot altar, we'll be able to get Nether Star aplenty. And that's mandatory because we want to complete the collector quest, Stars in Their Eyes. And that's the only way we're going to be able to do that. So we're not going to get into that this episode, but I'm not going to need any Nether Star anytime soon. I needed to do it in the last episode. Then we wanted to complete the Think Kapow Simple Yet Effective quest, and we completed one of the two, but we ran out of Ender Pearl to create a second Breath of the Dragon and make the Furnace Generator Mark II. We did complete Basic Survival, though. We completed the Killing quest, and this made the second quest line completed. Well, second, because Creating Life was the first one we ever finished completely. Basic Survival is the second, and we also completed Technological Revolution by doing the Power of the Dragon quest by crafting a Dragon's Breath. So now we only have three quest lines left. Think a Pow, Creating Life, Moving Worlds, and Collector. And the Collector is the long-term one, but Moving World, I've been playing it on my second playthrough, and it's such an arduous quest. I haven't got to the new home yet. I'm still trying to figure that out. So we're going to try and craft all of these machines today and complete as many of those quests today. And whenever we can, we're going to take a quick look to make sure that our Nether Stars, that we have 4 Ender Pearl to craft the other Dragon's Breath. And I say 4, but it's not 4, it's 6, if I remember correctly. Let's just look at the recipe so that we don't make a mistake out of this. So to craft it, we need, we need 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, where the stable Ender Pearl are made like this. And I'm just going to, transform one of the Nether Pearl into a stable, so that's one less to worry about. There's a lot of things to craft in this episode. And one of the things that we're stuck on right now is the Ardite ore. We only have 7 broken Ardite, which means we can craft 1 Ardite ingot. So this is really not a long-term solution. Let me take the titanium dust, and I'm going to throw it in the furnace here, which always get really stuck on platinum ingot. So that's a bad thing that I'm going to have to fix, but I'm going to do that in a time lapse. I'm basically just going to redirect the platinum ore somewhere else so that I don't have to deal with it until I need some. Because of the quest that we're going to create, I'm going to need to have 20 gold dust. And we already have 1 here, so I'm just going to make 19. And we're going to need 20 copper dust. And I'll explain to you why in a moment. I just want to get this started by putting this in here. So by putting this in here, and I'll grab some coal. I'll just do them in the sag mill and come back to it later. I'll go upstairs and I'll get some clay also to start cooking some clay, because I'm going to need a lot of material, and it's all going to be made very clear to you what I need and why. But in the meantime, I just need to get these things started just to make sure that we're able to complete everything that I want to complete today. It's going to be a lot of crafting and a lot of putting things down. So let's come right here and grab this and make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stack. Did that fit? Yeah, and I still have some space of clay into brick, and I'll put that in here for the time being. Let me check if this completed. Yes, it did. So let's start the other 19. I'm going to grab some infested leaf because we're going to need still more, the slime balls. I'm going to put this in, and this is about to break, so let's get a mesh right now. And pretty soon we're going to have to resolve our Netherrack line. Upstairs not creating Netherrack quickly enough. And talking about that, I'm going to grab everything I have and keep 4 that I'm going to cook and put the rest in there so that they... Oh, only 3. I don't know what's going on with this. I don't know why it's going so slow. And I think I have some already in my ME system, so I'm going to grab it right now because I'm going to need some. And again, I'm going to explain everything why I need all of this. Let's throw this in. Let's put this right here while there isn't a lot of space left. And this is done. So while all these resources are done, I want to start with one of the tips and tricks. And for that, I'm going to be crafting some oak barrel. So first, let's craft some oak wood slab. I'm going to make 12 oak barrel. And I'm creating those because I want to augment our dirt farm because we really need to be ramping it up. We need 100,000. Where's the conduit probe? So I've already crafted a conduit probe in a previous episode. That's why I'm not crafting another one. And we got this one as a in a quest reward. And I'm going to show you why. Like, I didn't know about that. And this is the first tip and tricks from Psoewish. I think she's the person that has given me the most tip in this game ever. So first, I'm going to be putting these four barrel down. When you have the conduit probe, I can click on this to get a lot of information about what it's connected to. And if I do it on a power, oh, sorry, on a power cable, I see that it's connected to a capacitor bank with a storage of 1 million, and the machine buffer has 3,939,000 RF, and that right now the average output is 640 every 5 seconds, over 5 seconds. But if I hold shift and I use the mouse scroll wheel, I now go into conduit probe copy mode. Remember when I told you how this was painful to set? I right click on this, oh sorry, shift right click on this, and I copied the conduit setting. And now if I go here and I add these on top of all of the barrels, now I can right click them and look at the arrow. It's going to become double arrow full setup and stuff are going to start getting into here. Again, again, and again. So when making a big farm, this is going to be very, very useful because I find this a laborious process when I had to copy everything one by one. Let me just make sure everything is lighted up properly, and I'll just continue adding some more. And this is the extent of the farm that I'm going to do for now. But either in a time lapse or in a another episode, I'm going to continue augmenting this farm because I want the dirt quest to complete as soon as possible. And I'm at 844, so I'm not even at 1% yet. And this is helping, but the other thing that might be helping is upgrading this pulverizer. So now that we've done all this, I'm going to put these things away again, and we're going to start talking about what we need to do for the moving worlds quest. We basically need to build an electric arc furnace, a lathe, a keep rolling, which is a rolling machine, a cutting wafer, which is a cutting machine, and a crystallizer. And for all of these quests, so if I look at this one, it says you need one output hatch, one input hatch, one electric arc furnace, one power input plug, one heat-proof brick, and one block of gold. But when you go into the yellow projector and shift right click, you have all of the machines. So let me take the electric arc furnace right now, and that's this pattern that's stored. I'm going to go outside because right now I don't have enough space inside to show you the blocks that are required to do this. And I'm going to do it on top of this right here so that no blocks are in the way. And then you can see the first level like I explained last time. So I quickly counted that's a 5x5 structure, so I need 25 heat-proof brick. Then I went up a level and I saw that I needed another 5x5, so 25 heat-proof brick, but not really because the front has to be an electric furnace, so that's 24. And you need at least one input and one output hatch. You see that these vary between input, output, and heat-proof brick because they can be interchanged. You need at least one input hatch to put resource in and one output hatch to take things out. But the rest is all heat-proof brick. And we don't need multiple in and out. This machine's so slow, it's not gonna matter. So I counted that I needed another 25 minus 3, so I needed 21. Then I went to the other level and I need a square with an empty center. So I counted 5, 10 plus 6, so 16. And then the next level was 3, 6, 9, 12 with 3. And this is the thing. The recipe got changed. The quest wants us to make a gold block, but what you really want are coils. And the coils are supposed to have a difference in speed. But whichever coil I made always gave me a speed of 1x. And I'm not understanding this. It's either a bug or something I'm not doing right. So I'm going to build some aluminum coil or a gold coil. I haven't decided yet. And I'm just going to go with these depending on which one's the easiest. Finally, the fifth and last level needs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 heat-proof brick and 3 power input plug. So if we look back at the quest, much more than what's written here, okay? And then if we look at the lathe, we need 1 input hatch, 1 power input plug, 1 machine structure, 1 output hatch, 1 lathe, and 1 motor. And here it's the basic motor. And if I look at the other quests for the keep rolling, this one wants an advanced motor. And finally, the cutting machine wants an enhanced motor. So we should be able to do everything except the enhanced motor. And the crystallizer is very basic with a fluid. This one doesn't have any fluid hatch, sorry. The fluid hatch is on the rolling machine. So while looking at all of those quests, I took some time in my other playthrough and I composed the list of everything we're going to need. And I'm going to just pause myself here for at least 5 seconds or 10 seconds, and let me put my screen somewhere where it's easy to read stuff. What would be the best background to make it easy to read? Okay, hopefully this is going to be a good background. And I'm going to put a list here of everything I figured that needed to be crafted to make everything for these machines. Basically, what I did is this. I went in the lathe, I put it down, and I said, okay, I need a power input plug, 2 machine structure, an output hatch, second level, an input hatch, a motor, and a lathe. And that was it. So then I shift right click, and I did this with the crystallizer, and clicked the crystallizer somewhere else. And I was like, okay, I need output hatch, input hatch, crystallizer, the ice power input, 2 coils, second level, 6 quartz crucible. Oh. 6 quart crucible, and I did this for every one of the machine, and I'm going to explain them as we build them. Don't forget, you can always left click on the block to make them disappear. So I know everything that I need to craft, and I'm going to do it all in one shot. And the order that I'm doing it is the list that you will have seen 5 minutes ago when I told you that I was going to show you this. So first off, we're going to need some plate, and a lot of plate. So I'm going to be crafting another engineer hammer because one's not going to be, is not going to be enough. Engineer hammer. And I'm going to craft a second one right now. And now I'm going to create some iron plate. So let's go with iron plate. And I'm going to craft a stack of that. We have enough iron. And this is just going to be easier that way. So a stack of iron plate. And I'm going to make a half a stack of tin plate. So this is the tin ingot, and I'm going to craft 32. I don't want to craft the whole stack because I'm never going to need the whole stack. Then I need some iron rod, and for the iron rod again, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to create a stack because we're going to need the stack anyway. Oh, sorry, this one. So shift click and a whole stack. So now that this is done, I need to start building everything. And I'm going to give you a quick look. I went through all of the recipe, and the first recipe I looked in is the machine structure. And the machine structure is built with 4 iron rod and 4 iron plate, and it's used in multiple crafting recipes. So if I can find it again, it's used in making the power input plug that we're going to need 7. It's used in making, what's the other one that it's used? The crystallizer you need one, the lathe you need one, the cutting machine you need one, the rolling machine you need one. And I'm ignoring a lot of machine, but we're going to have to build all of these. I'm just going to prepare them in the episode where I need them. And by doing this, I discovered that I needed 32 machine frame, machine, no, not machine frame, sorry, machine casing. not casing, what is it called? Sorry, machine structure. So I'm gonna go and craft 36. Now I think I'm gonna be missing some of these. And I need to craft, I need to craft 7 sets of small battery. Oh, I can't write 7 here. 7 set of small battery like so. So 1 set, 2 set, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 sets of small battery. And the reason we're crafting 7 sets of small battery is that we need 7 power input block. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Perfect. Then we need to craft some heat-proof brick. So let's go look at the heat-proof brick recipe, and it's crafted like so. And this, we're going to need 81. So let's create 16 of these, because anyway, we're going to use them for magma block if we don't need them for anything else. And let's craft a whole stack of brick. And now 16, we're going to craft a whole stack of this. And half a stack is, more than half a stack. So 100, we have 100, which is enough. And we're going to use more later on anyway, so I'm not too worried about creating too many. Then for each of the machine, if I look at the lathe, for example, we need these steel gear, steel plate, and we need these control circuit board, item IO circuit board, and user interface. So quickly, sorry, let me go upstairs and grab some cactus and make sure that my steel production is going well. So I'm just going to grab whatever cactus are around, because we're going to need some green dye, and the only way to get green dye that I know of is to cook some cactus. So I'm going to put some in the smeltery furnace. I'm just going to replant this, and it's about time because night is coming back. And we're going to go back safe inside. Perfect. So let's go back safe inside and start cooking these. And all of these I had to figure all before, because I would have spent 3 episodes crafting each one separately, one at a time. So now that these are cooking, let's go back in here and continue. The other thing that we need to make are the control circuit. So let's look at the item IO circuit board. The item IO circuit board is crafted like so. It's going to need iron plates, and we created more, and crushed gold. And we need 5 of them, which is why we needed the 20 gold powder or gold dust. Let's create some oak wood slab, and I'm just going to craft a couple and throw in there. And this we should be able to shift click in now, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm going to put it back in my ME system, because I'm going to use them to craft something else. Then I'm going to look at the control circuit, which is this one, and this one's made out of copper, which is why we needed the copper. Again, this is 5, and put it in here. Then there's one that we only need one of, which is the liquid circuit. And this one's made from lapis, which is why I didn't need to break down more of another resource. And in my other playthrough, I shift-clicked this, and I created like 40 of them when I didn't need that many. Then we need to make the steel gear and the steel steel rod. So let me look at the recipe for the lathe again so I can find the steel gear recipe. The steel gear recipe is made from steel rod, steel plate, and a steel ingot. Oh no, that's the hard one. I think there's something not fair about this. Do you see this recipe? 4 steel ingot and an iron. Or I can do this recipe, which is 2 steel plate plus a 3rd steel, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4 steel and 4 steel rod. And steel rod are crafted with 2, so that's 5. Well, is it the same? Let me check this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 5, sorry, that's 2. So again, one last time. All of this is created by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this one's created with 4. Okay, so this one's easier. So let's make this one to save 1 steel, and we need 5 steel gear. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we need some steel plate. We need 4 steel plate. Not that kind of steel plate. Again, I want to use the immersive engineering one because it's the easiest one. Why not use the easiest one that we can craft? So 4 steel plate. With that, we're also going to need some iron block. So let's make some iron block right now. We're going to need 2 of them. 1, 2. We need obsidian, we already have. We need iron plate that we already made. We need an iron saw blade. I'm trying to make all of the basic material right now so that when we get into crafting the more complex thing, everything is ready. Then we need two redstone repeater are crafted like so. So I'm gonna need four redstone torch, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we can craft these two redstone repeater. Now we have everything to be able to complete the machines. So first, the electric arc furnace. Electric arc furnace is crafted like so. One control circuit board, one item IO circuit board, a user interface, a heatproof brick, four nether brick, and a copper. And we have, I thought we had everything to craft that. Oh no, we never did the user interface. So I'm still missing the user interface, and that's because this hadn't cooked yet. So let's grab all of this and let's put everything in there and let's look at it again. Electric arc furnace, which is right here. And we need five of these user interface. So we're going to need 10 lime dye, 10 like so. So let's create the five user interface, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and put it in there. So now we can make our electric arc furnace. So electric arc furnace. And then the second machine we want to make is the lathe, which is crafted like so. The third machine we want to make is the rolling machine, which is crafted with the two iron block that we needed to make. So third machine, head or core, we might say, is done. The next one is the cutting machine. And I'm going to explain all of these machines. We're all going to set them down and we're going to use all of them at least once. Then the saw blade assembly, which uses the saw blade. That's why we made the saw blade first, like so. And then we need finally a crystallizer, which this one has the two redstone repeater and some quartz. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 machine. The next thing we need are quartz crucible, and we need 6 of those. So I'm gonna make 6 crucible, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this is so resource intensive. I'm happy that we set up the line earlier and that everything's easy now. So these were all the set machine, everything we needed like for the heart of the machines. But now we need all of the component. And we started with the power input plug, which I'm not happy about because I wanted to craft this in order and I should have done all of these first. But we have the 7 power input plug. Why 7? 1 for this machine, 2, 3, 4, and 3 for the electric furnace. So 4 plus 3 equals 7. Then we need the input output hatch. So I'm just going to search for hatch because these are all the hatch that I want. And the input hatch are a machine structure with an oak chest on top. The input hatch, we need 5. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I'm out of chest. That's going to be quickly resolved. I can't believe that I ran out of chest. Let's make a whole stack so that this never happens again. Wood is so cheap. So 2, 3, 4, 5. The difference between the input and the output is just this. You put reverse. And now we need 5 output hatch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we need copper, some coils. Well, we're gonna need a gold block just for the quest. So we're going to make one gold block that we're going to ignore, but then we're going to need some coil. So I'm gonna use, I really couldn't find any information about which one are the most efficient. Since I have aluminum the most, I'm going to make 7 aluminum coil for now. And I'm going to continue investigating in my other world how much, what's the difference and which one's the best later, because I don't want to waste time now. So 5 output hatch, 5 input hatch, 7 copper, well, aluminum coil, 7 power input plug. We need also a fluid input hatch, and this one's a bit more complicated. The fluid input hatch requires a liquid fuel tank, which is crafted like this, and we don't have any of it because I completely forgot that we would need these plate, not these type of plate. I just need to wait for the right one to cycle, this one. So 1, 2, and I need the steel rod also, and 4. Now I should be able to do this, and thankfully, I'm sorry, not what I wanted to click. Thankfully, I'm doing recording the video before I'm putting the annotation, so I'm going to update the recipe to tell you that you need these steel plates and steel rod. So one liquid fuel tank that I'm going to put in here so that we can use it in creating a fluid hatch, like so. And now we're going to grab all of our machine frame because we need them in our crafting recipe. The last thing that we need are mortars. And the mortars, I want to use the most epic of all mortars. I want to use these all the time, but I don't have iridium yet. I haven't figured out how to make iridium. Not even in, well, I have figured out, but it's a complicated process that I'm not ready yet. I need to make one enhanced mortar, but the enhanced mortar wants titanium plate. And if you look at the titanium plate, there are only three ways to make it: with a rolling machine, with the small plate presser, where it's going to cost me 9 titanium for 4, and that's too expensive. I don't have that much titanium. Or a metal press, which I never built in this playthrough. So I'm not going to make the enhanced mortar now. I'm going to craft the mortar, which is, oh, I also forgot the plates for this. So thank God I'm going to be able to update everything on time so that when you watch this, you won't have the derp of being of missing stuff. I need 2 copper coil for this one mortar. So let's craft this mortar. And then we need more steel plate again here. So 3 more. 1, 2, 3 more for this. And some gold coil. So 2 gold coil right here. And I'm going to make the advanced mortar. And I can't craft the enhanced mortar now, so I'm going to stop here. So let's look at all of the quests that updated and completed. We've completed the electric arc furnace because we crafted everything we needed for it, and there's no claiming, it doesn't give you any reward. For the lathe, I'm not missing anything, but I need to claim the quest, so 2 loot chests. Then for the keep rolling, again, I have crafted everything that I need, so I can also claim this quest. For the cutting wafer, I'm missing the enhanced mortar, which is why I want to put down the keep rolling machine to be able to create the platinum. For the crystallizer, I have all of the parts for the crystallizer, but I don't have the silicone boule, which are going to be made with a crystallizer. So we now need to go put down these machines. I'm just going to open the loot, a presser, not important, 10 stone, a stick and 20 cobweb, and 5 cobblestone. My loot chest, we're getting further and further in the game, but our rewards are not getting better, which I find a bit sad, but you know, it is what it is, and it's not like the quests have been game changer for me anyway. So let's go put that back in there, and let's start setting up the machine. Oh, not the ME drive. Let's start setting up the machine. My one biggest problem is that the electric arc furnace is too high. So I need to break this a little bit to make it lower. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put the machines around here because I want them close to this reactor that we're going to make better soon, because we're going to need a lot more power. So let me take my hammer and I'm just going to break this down right here and go 3 lower should be enough. So 1, 2, 3, and I want to build the floor, so let's say 4. And I'm going to go down to my wall, and on this level, that's where I'm going to craft the multiple electric arc furnace that I'm going to need. I think that in a time lapse, I'm probably going to craft 3 more so that I can have 4 electric arc furnace. Whoa! Oh, that's a good thing I didn't do that at night, because that would have been bad. Opening up the base at night, that would have been bad. Although I have 8 life, so I'm pretty sure I would have been fine. But I have to be more careful when doing these things. So let's continue going down that way. And I'm just going to quickly count to make sure that I have enough space to put the 4 that I want to put. And how far am I? I'm hoping I'm getting to it soon. Oh, again, 1 too far. And as you can see, this is flying all over me, so I'm going to have to put some back in my ME system. And I'm too far for that, so I'm going to go back here quickly and push the sand in my Emmy system. And you know what? I'm probably just going to push the sand in my looting bag so that this doesn't take forever. These machines take 5x5, and I want to have a border around, so 1, 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2 space. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm missing 2 more down, so I'm going to break 1, 2, 3 this way so that we can build the wall. And like this. And then I can complete this way, and I'm going to make the same count. Again, I want to be able... Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. I want to be able to put 4 of them in this corner. So 1, 2... Ugh, this is broken, really? I'm using a lot of steel on this, and I'm going to have to probably smelt more steel just to be able to repair... Ah, yeah, just one more steel sharpening kit. So let me just... Ah, no, that one's not steel. What am I saying? This one's iron, and I still have 2 more. Let's take the 2 more because I have a strong feeling that I'm going to need the 2 more. So let's repair it once, and let's continue digging as fast as I can so that we can start setting this up. And I'm just going to make enough space to put 1 down because I want to show you 1. And I want to complete this video by putting down all of the machine and testing each one of them. So again, this is out. And I'm going to need to put some torch to make sure nothing spawns in here. That would be very bad. Let's continue like this. And this is going to be enough for sure. And we're going to be able to start... Oh, I almost went under the sand. So I'm going to be able to put it down. I need to take this out also. And this and this. And I don't have enough torch upstairs. So I'm going to have to be careful with the upstairs part. Perfect. So we're ready to craft stuff. Let's put everything out here like so. And I really know what I need to build. So I'm just going to take everything that I need. I need the heat-proof brick, I need the electric arc furnace, I'm going to need some power input plug, the output hatch, the input hatch, and that's it. So let me get my Olo projector and let's get this started. Shift right click, and go find the electric arc furnace and select it. So the wall's going to be here, so we're really starting here. 1, 2, this one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the center of the machine. And it's barely a fit. So let's cut down 1 more down that way just so that we're not this tight when building the machine. Like this. And it's really easy to follow. I love these kinds of structures to tell you how to build stuff. I think that they're genius. I don't know how they're done, but they're really incredible, or else some of these structures could be really hard to build. So I'm gonna need 25 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then third. Again, and you just put them in, and as they get put in, they replace. Now we go on the low projector, hold shift, and mouse wheel up. This is the second level. And this is how I'm going to build the electric arc furnace. I'm going to put it front here, and I'm going to put an input on the left and an output on the right. And I'm going to make everything else out of heat-proof brick because I don't need multiple in and out. I'm only dealing with one kind of material. And since I'm going to build 4 of these, if I wanted to use one for other kind of resource, I could just do it this way. Sorry, let me go to the options. The sound, and let's take the friendly creature sound down way down. I didn't know I was right under my I want to say elephant farm, but I mean cow farm. Next level is all heat proof brick, so, and just in a surrounding pattern. So let's complete filling this in like so, and I'm not gonna set more than 1. I didn't even craft more than enough for 1 recipe right now anyway. So this is just like the side without the corners, like a smeltery. And the last thing that we're going to need are the coils. And as I told you, we've crafted the aluminum coil because I haven't figured out what's the power difference between each of them. Finally, the last level, is one power input over each of the coil. So there's a coil here, and a coil here. And I can close the rest with heat-proof brick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this machine is completed. Let's empty this out of my end and right-click it. And you see that it's working. Electric arc furnace, and you can turn them on or off. And you see the speed 1 and the power 1. I've tried putting different coil, and I've never seen a speed other than 1. I don't know if it's a display bug or if it's really not doing it faster. So for the time being, I'm not going to try and make this faster. Let me get my tech and crafting and see if I have any power cable. I don't have any power cable in this one. Let me look at my main. Do I have any power cable in this one? I don't have any power cable in that one either. So I'm just going to go take a quick look and see if we have any power cable in the ME system, and if not, if we have enough resource to craft some. How did I build this so far? Wow. Will I even be able to put another one on site? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I won't even be able to put a second one on the side. I thought I knew how to count, but obviously I don't know how to count. And it's bugging me so much that in a time lapse, I might even move it out of the way. But for now, let's just go see if we have some power conduit. And we have some conductive iron, so we can make power conduit. Let's craft the maximum we can, because we're going to need more than we probably have. So let's not even take any chance. Let's grab some iron. Iron. A stack of iron. Let's get a stack of redstone also, and let's put all of this in the furnace, well, not the furnace, in the alloy smelter, so that when I come back, no, I keep doing this. I don't know why I keep using the wrong machine so much that I should probably put a sign on it that says, don't click on this machine unless you're really sure that's the machine you want to click. Anyway, so let's go back here. And let's use the power directly from this. So in a line from here, I'm going to start grabbing the power from here and bring it back here, which now is taking more cable because I put it too far. So it's really a double derp, but it seems to be these days that I don't have an episode unless I have at least one derp. So let me bring that right here like this, and then across and on each side, and this should be powered. And let me look at it. It's powered, and I should turn it on. And now I wish I'd kept some sand. Oh, yes, I have some in my looting bag. We're going to fill it with sand. And why are we going to fill it with sand? Because we need silicon. And you're going to say, well, you already have silicon, but no, we need a specific type of silicone to make silicone bowl. So this is going to start working, and I don't know why it doesn't show yet, but it's already working. It just seems to take a while before it registers. And you don't have any recipe marker. So let me just quickly do a research on silicone. And this is the one that we already know how to craft. What is it called, though? Electric arc furnace. What if I right-click? Does it show the recipe? Yeah, silicon ingot, which I can't find when I write silicon. But it's done with sand through the electric furnace, and you have to wait the whole process. You can also make steel, but we already have a machine to make steel upstairs. And titanium aluminide ingot is done like this. Titanium iridium ingots and titanium ingot, but we don't have rutile ore yet. Oh, and you see it started. You see it's very slow. And we're going to need at least 5 of these to be able to make the 4 boule. So while we're waiting for this, let's come back right here. And this is where we're going to build the machines that we want, the other machines that we want. The first one that we want to build is the rolling machine. And the reason we want to build the rolling machine first is that the rolling machine is the one that's going to permit us crafting the plates that we need for the last motor. So the power input plug is here, so I don't want to build it this way then. Then I want to put it on that side. And that's too much on the side, so I'm going to move it one more this way, like so. Yeah, perfect. I like the position here. So power input plug. The only one fluid input hatch goes right here. I'm going to need 2 coil. Let's put the 2 coil back here and here. Then we need some machine structure. one, two, three, four machine structure. We need an engine here. Since we're going to use this machine the least of all, I'm going to put the basic motor right here. And then we need two output hatch right here, one and two. So that's the first level. Let's take the auto projector and look at the second level. The second level wants the rolling machine head right here. Rolling machine head right here. It wants some more machine structure that I put out of my hotbar. Dope. I'm not sure that's a machine frame here. And two input hatch right here. One, two. And just to make sure if it works, we'll know right now. Right click and beautiful. Look at this machine. It's wonderful. So you put thing on this side in the input hatch and things are gonna come out in this output hatch. With only one problem, we need H2O. So let's quickly go back here and we're going to need three. So let's take one, two, three titanium ingot that we're going to bring right here and put in the input. So titanium in the input, and we're going to need power cable. And I would like them out of the way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have them go from under, right here. One, two, and I'm going to have the power connect from under like this. And I'm going to bring it across to connect to the electric arc furnace. One more, and what's the next step? I need to go up one and one, up one and one again. Perfect. So now it's connected. It should have power. Yeah, it's fully powered, but it's not rolling anything. Let's turn it on, and it's still not rolling anything. And why is it not rolling anything? Because it doesn't have any water. So let's quickly go grab 4 buckets of water. I think that 4 buckets of water will be enough to craft my 3 titanium plate. But just to not take any chance, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab the whole barrel and bring it downstairs. I honestly haven't connected it yet, and it doesn't matter for the time being. So I'll just put that down right here and go like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'll click into this and put all of them in. And I'll just put a second set to make sure. And you can hear the sound of the machine. They make some nice machine sound, and I like them. And I think it's already done, and you see things rolling. Where are my titanium iron something? Gone from here. Oh, they're still here. So it's working, but slowly. Oh, you see an ingot going through. See? The ingot goes through, gets pressed into a plate, and so on and so on, and it's super nice, the animation and everything. So let's grab the 3 titanium plate and let's go back here so that we can craft the enhanced motor, which was the only thing that we were missing. So the motor, enhanced motor needed these 3 plates, 2 aluminum coils, so 1, 2, let's put them in here, and these titanium rod like this, and we should be able to craft this now. And it's crafted, and let's go look at the reward, the quest, because this is now our 1, 2, 3. Oh, it's not even completing a 4th quest, because this obviously wants us to craft silicon wafer. And to craft silicon wafer, we need silicon boule, which are these here. And to craft the silicon boule, we need 5 silicon ingot. And if I go back here, I'm going to show you I don't even have one crafted yet. See? Not even one. This is how slow this is. And when this reaches here, you might think it's finished, but it isn't. You have to go up all of this. So by the end of this episode, we won't even have what we need. Let's now make the second machine where's my auto projector? And we're going to build the lathe next. So the lathe is 3, 4 large, and I don't want it like this. I'm going to put it one more this side. Yeah, perfect. And I'm not going to put it on this side because, again, what did I say? I want the power output to be on the same side. Perfect, like this. So I'm going to need the power output are right here. I'm going to need 2 power structure. Where are my machine structure? 1, 2. I'm going to need an output hatch. Where's my output hatch? Right here. And I'm going to need some input hatch, so I might as well do it right now. Let's look at the second level. The second level is now an input hatch, an enhanced motor, well, a motor, whichever one, and a lathe. So input hatch right here, the lathe right there. So where's the lathe? The lathe. I'm not sure about the pronunciation. That's me being a Frenchie. Again, this is a machine that we're not going to use so much. So let's put the advanced motor and keep the enhanced motor for one that we're going to use more. And look at this beautiful machine. These machines are really nice. We're going to go from under again, like this. Oh, like this. And we're going to bring the power connector across. And already I can see I'm going to run out. That's why we made some more before. And let's grab it. Perfect. And it's connected. It should have power. This one doesn't require water. It's much easier. And I don't need to use it. But like I said, I want to show you how it works. These machines are really, really, really well made and really exciting. So let's make some iron rod. I'm going to grab four of these. And I'm going to go in the input hatch and put four iron ingot. And I'm going to click on start the machine. And look at this. It puts a rod here and you see the machine go through. And I'm going to shut up now so you can hear. Reaches the end. Comes back and again, and they drop in here. See? Two iron rod. So it's one for two and two for four. So it's about the same ratio. We're not saving any materials in rolling the plates nor in doing this, which is a bit sad, but it is what it is. It's like I keep saying these episodes. Last machine, well, not last machine. The next machine is the cutting machine. This one is kind of interesting and I'm going to put it right here. Ooh, I just want to check where the power cable is. The power's back here. And the cutting machine is right in front here. So yeah, this is a good position with two in front. So let's put it right here. Do I have any machine structure? No, I have an output and an input and the cutting machine. So not crystallizer, cutting machine, output, input. Output, input, and cutting machine. Then I need the saw blade assembly, a motor, and some power input. The power input goes right here. The saw blade assembly goes here. And we're going to use this machine some more than the others because we're going to make a lot of wafer. Let's put the advanced motor on this one. Now let's look at the second level. Huh? Let's look at the second. Oi, what's the second level? Oh no, there's no second level on this machine. Derp. I keep on forgetting. This is a very simple machine. Right click and it transforms. It has a cool animation of the things going across and being cut. But now we don't have enough power cable. So let's go back here and craft some more energy conduit right here like so. I need these. That's why I crafted them. So let's put them right here. And I know that this episode is running long. And I know I said I was going to try to keep the episode shorter. But when I have a goal in mind of something that I want to build, I find it crazy to just say, oh, well, I didn't finish the build. Too bad. I'll show you in the next episode. Which is why I'm just trying to finish this. And where's the power? Oh, the power is not where I was expecting it. So let's go another 1, 2, 3, 4 down that way. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And right here. No! I'm going to have a lot of rebuilding to do after this episode to make everything clean. So let's bring the conduit right here and across like so. And not in the hole. And it's connected, so now I should be able to see it work. And let's come right here. So let me quickly check if I can find any recipe. Oh, yeah. Easy. Let me grab some wood. It cuts wood. I'm not sure how useful that is, but it does cut wood. So I can show you an example with this. And let's just do 8. The input hatch is here. Let's put this in. Let's turn the machine on and look at this. It goes through like this. And this one makes no noise, or my noise bugged out already, again. So that's another machine, and now we can craft the last machine that we have everything for today, which is the crystallizer, another very important machine. So let's see right here. I want two space just like I did for this one. The power input plug is here. The interface is on this side. Yeah, okay, so let's put it on the other side. Even though it's not too close. Let's put it on the other side right like this. Yes, two space, perfect. So power plug back here. We need two coils, coil and coil. We need the crystallizer. Oh, I'm missing an output input hatch. Okay, so I'm going to update my recipe list. Unfortunately, I had enough machine structure. I counted that properly. So let's quickly craft those. One input hatch and one output hatch. And we're going to need a lot more of these, by the way, to make the other machines. But for now, this should be enough. So output on this side, input on this side. Let's look at the second level. In the second level are the 6-quart crucible. So let's put the 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's turn the machine. Beautiful. And another machine done. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to start from here to dig so that I can easily find where to go. And the easiest is going to be to go across. Yeah. So I'm just going to dig 2 or 3 down and go across like this. Can I reach it from here? Yes, perfect. So let's bring the power cable right here. And I don't need this, so let's break that one. And I'm going to fill in the hole later, don't worry. And this machine can be turned on. And this one you see has a speed of 381. I think this is based on the fact that we're using aluminum coil. So maybe I could break this machine and use this machine to know which coils are the better in case that this is just a display bug. But all of our machines are working. I can't show you this one or that one unless I get more silicon. So let me go down here and I only have one silicon. So I can't show you right now how it works. The second one's going to be ready in a little while, because to craft the silicon boule, if I go back here and I say boule, like so, you need one silicon ingot and one silicon nugget. And you get the silicon nugget by breaking an ingot. So I'm going to need one ingot to create 9 silicon nugget and 4 ingot for the quest to craft the 4 silicon boule. And before I put the bull into wafer, I'm going to register the quest. So that's going to be it for this episode. We've completed a lot of quests and we've moved along a lot. I'm going to look at the time of the episode, and I'm pretty sure I'm not going to include any time lapse into this one because I went way overboard. I think I'm already at an hour. If I'm at less than 40, if I'm at 40 minutes, I'll include a time lapse of 5 minutes where I'm going to finish digging all of this and replacing the machine there so I can put 3 more, and I might even craft the 3 more, but that's probably going to be it. And just one last thing. I say the episode's too long, but I can't stop myself and I have to go check. Only one Ender Pearl, so I can't even complete that quest in the next, probably in the next episode, but I'm not sure. So in the next episode, we're going to be spending some time on making the collector quest better, hopefully finishing the Tinkapow quest line by crafting the big steam. Oh no, we can't because we need yet another modifier. So we're going to get into environmental tech, and I'm going to show you how we're going to get our hardite faster. So that's probably going to be what the next episode is while we're waiting for the advanced rocketry to get its head in the game and give us the resource we need. So guys, that's it for today's episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye now!